Welcome to Ocean Cay. Oh yeah, so we're just getting off the ship. Wow, it feels really good out here. It is, has a nice breeze as you can see from the trees. I mean, it feels like it's probably like in the 70s right now, but it is, we're in a shaded area and I'm pretty sure that the temperature is gonna get higher once we get into some sun. So as you can see, we just got off of there. This is our ship. And we're just gonna just walk around this private island. This is a marine reserve. We're gonna get some food. And then later tonight, there's a beach party and also a light show. So I'm gonna be able to show you all of that today. And this is my first time being here, but it's a very bright, open, private island. All right, let's check it out. So as you come through, this is the area for if you're a yacht club guest, where you can wait for your excursions or any services that you may need. And then they're setting up an area right here for live music. And we're gonna continue on. Let me show you guys where we're located at. All right, so we're currently right over here. So you have the Smugglers Bar, Smiling Fish, Ocean Village. This is a nice map of the island. So we're basically going to be going to the right, to Springer's Bar, Smiling Fish, and we're gonna go over to the Secret Family Cove and then make our way over to the Ocean House and then come down this way. All right, next stop is the rental and excursion area, where if you want to do any rentals of anything that's here or any excursion, this is where you would go. We have the visitor center to the left. And then there's some shops along this way. Beautiful, beautiful area. Man. Let's see. Oh yeah, so this is an MSC shop here. I'll go in them later because this is as closer to the entrance. And then we have the management office. Ooh. But we have a souvenir Ocean Cay souvenir shop. And then we have a Bahamas shop over across from it. All right, one good thing too about this island or this private island is that you can use your, if you have a drink package, you can utilize that at all the bars, places to eat around this private island. So that's something that is really, really good. And I'm gonna definitely see how much different places there is to eat. But we're approaching Springer's Bar. I'm gonna go grab me a drink. this bar wraps all the way around. You got plenty of seating, even areas where people can, you know, if you're a smoker, it's right here by the water. Got my rum punch. My mom got this blue curacao mixed drink. Feels good out here, guys. Really, really good. And one thing that they don't have here is plastic or paper straws. And I'm contributing to it being that this is a marine reserve and they're trying to obviously preserve this island and eliminating the amount of waste. It's a good thing. All right, so we just left from there. And you can see all of these houses or townhomes, as you may call it in the States. These are all residences of the members of the island that work here. So they stay in these houses or apartments. Really, really nice that they MSC has this for them. All right, so we've, But yeah, here is a secret food court. This is the complimentary buffet area. As you can see, they have plenty of seating in this area. It's just like, you know, your standard private island. They have the complimentary food. And then you have part of the marine, the Seeker's Cove over here. We don't see, yeah, this is this area, as you see, there are certain areas that they purposely preserve because the sea turtles, they'll come up ashore. So this area is not accessible by any of the guests and the cruise passengers. So I think I'm gonna get in line and get something to eat because I did not have breakfast. So we're gonna see what they have over here. But yeah. All right, so while you're here, they have two different lines. There's a line over there and this line right here. I'm gonna grab our plates. There's a buffet area. You could also have drinks on each side. So there's an area right here that you can get drinks. And then all the way on that side is where you can get drinks as well. And then all the way in the back, I think it's like a grill area back there. And as like I said, they were seating all over the place. So one really good thing they have is they have a wash station right here. As soon as you come on board, well, not on board, but as soon as you enter this area, they also have a hand sanitizer. So between washing hands and the hand sanitizer, they're, you know, definitely have it. You can see gentleman right there, he's washing hands. So they're making you wash your hands before you come into this area. So kudos to MSC on that. Kudos. Alright guys, so we are located right here. We walked from the ship over to right here. This is where Seeker's at. It's where we have food. And then we're gonna make our way up by Secret Family Cove and over to the Orange Beach House and come down here and then make our way back. So as far as the food was, you know, your standard, you know, private island food. You know, they had salad, they had, you know, fruits, fries, burgers, hot dogs. They had some chicken, they had ribs. And I got the hot dogs and burger, fries, got some fruit, got some cookies. Cookies was good. So, you know, nice area. But check out another area not too far from here where it's also free. So you have these, let me show you guys. So you have these food trucks right here, and they have different food here. So for instance, this beach shack has hot dogs, hamburgers, cheeseburgers, brownies, pasta, and similar over here as well. This is also included. You don't have to pay for this. All right, but check out the beach area. You got you. They do have a shuttle that goes around this area. It's called the Transport Pavilion. You sit here and they'll pick you up. And then, there's another bar, which I'm about to go to. Right over here. Oh, give me another drink. All right, so we have another beach shack, but this one actually, there is a charge to it, but it's more so because they're selling seafood here. So we're just making our way around. This area to another bar. But that's where basically where we can kind of sit at and not have to be actually like on the beach. That's the reason why we're stopping. So okay, they also have the shuttles that's available where you can wait for them, which I think we're about to approach one coming up here. But as you can see, as I mentioned to you all earlier, here's another angle of where this area right here is enclosed to the public because they're preserving this area because of the sea turtles that come and migrate up here. All right, so one thing the MSC does, they have a crew cove in this area of Ocean Cay. Is for crew members only. So as you see, they got a little privacy here and enables for the crew to kind of enjoy themselves here at Ocean Cay. So that's really, really good that they do that. And they have a nice area to kind of relax and chill out over here. Thank you. guys, so now we are about to walk over to North Island, which is over in this section right here. And I'm about to get ran over by the transportation. And here is, well, this is for Yacht Club members only. They get their own transportation. But there's other transportation for people who are not part of the Yacht Club. All right, so over in this section is where you have the Ocean House, the Yacht Club, from Yacht Club members only. They have their own beach area. And I'm not sure if they also have, I'm pretty sure they have a bar and a place to eat over here as well. All right, so over here in North Island, now this is the Atlantic Ocean. And over in this side, this particular area does not have a lifeguard. So no lifeguard on duty, and swim at your own risk. And you can definitely tell that you know, it's not as calm as the little marine area where we're just at. But I'm gonna walk over from this bar area, which is called Disc. This bar, and check out this other area. I'm not sure if this other area is for Yacht Club. I didn't see anything that was indicating that was for Yacht Club, but it might be. To be honest with you, there's really nothing over in this area. There are some, looks like some cabanas placed around this area over here. So I'm not gonna really spend too much time down over here. More food. And we have the Maze Bar over here on North Island. Yeah, that bar is open. Someone said that this bar right here wasn't open. It's definitely open. I knew I seen people from the other side, but
maybe at the time, maybe he came early morning. You know, when they first set him off, it wasn't right.
Yeah, I think this is where the restrooms are over here. Yep. Restrooms, showers. It's all located over here. So. All right, guys. So I'm making my way over to the lighthouse, which is kind of close to the lighthouse right over there. Wow. The direction. And it's a nice walk over from the Streakers area. And so I heard that there's a bar over here. So I'm gonna check out this bar and see how that is. To go in the lighthouse, I think they said it's about $10 to walk up the lighthouse, take photos, which I don't know if I can do it right here or not. I'll see. If I can, I might spend the $10, go up there, get some more photos, videos for you guys, so you can kind of see how vast this private island is. So, oh, I see another bar, guys. I feel like I'm just bar hopping. I'm just bar hopping. So that's what I'm gonna do. There's another bar over here. We're gonna check it out. I can't say over here, it is not that many people over here. So we're in the lighthouse. And I'm gonna show you all where I'm located at so you all know. So the lighthouse is to the left. Then you have the lighthouse bar, which that's over by the lighthouse. But North Island is at the spot, Ocean Cay is that direction. So over here is where the spire is. And there's another bar right there. Really, really, let's walk over here. Oh, this one has a little, like a little patio area. We're going to check it out. guy. You hear this music? My man over there. He's killing it. Just relaxing over here by the lighthouse bar. Man, some beautiful views. As you can see, just drinking, just relaxing, something like cruising. Let me get off of here before YouTube copyright me. More to come. Beach party, lighthouse light show coming up soon. All right, guys, so just spent about an hour or so at the lighthouse bar. And now I'm headed back to change and get ready for dinner. And then back out here on the island for the beach bash and the lighthouse light show. So, what a beautiful island. I would say, I have to do some thinking where this ranks with other private islands, because I've been to Honeymoon Cay or Carnival. I've been to Perfect Day at Coco Cay, but Perfect Day at Coco Cay is still number one. So this is a beautiful island. Royal Caribbean Perfect Day at Coco Cay is just, it's because it's not only is a beautiful island, but it has a lot of extra things on there to do as well, such as the water park, where here it's just basically beach. There's no pools or anything here where I feel like if they have a chance, they do have a big enough area. Like right over here is a huge area where they can make a pool, but I don't know how that will work as far as this being kind of like a marine reserve. But if they add that, that'll just bring another element to this private island, which is already beautiful. But I can say this. As far as the water goes, Half Moon Cay or Carnival is just absolutely beautiful. So I probably would rank this probably maybe, I haven't been to Norwegian's private island yet. So I've been to Disney. There's a couple private islands I have not been to. I've been to other ports. And I need to kind of get to those other private islands so I can kind of compare. But I would say right now, of all the private islands I've been to, this would be number two behind Royal Caribbean, and Half Moon Cay would be number three, because Carnival's private island is just nothing but, it's similar to this, but it's not as big. Well, I could be lying, it might be as big. I don't think it's as big, but really, as soon as you get off of the tender or the water shuttle, it's nothing but beach right there, and that's it. Here is like, you can really like go around the whole island, and you know, there's different beaches you can go to. Like North Island and South Island beaches are a little bit different as far as like, as from what I saw, as far as how the water, calm the water was versus like North Island looked like the water was a little bit more rough. Right over here by the lighthouse as well, the water looked a little bit rough. But you have the, like the little lagoon in the middle, which has calm waters. So you can kind of pick and choose where you want to go. Whereas Half Moon Cay, it's like, you only have like one choice. Unless you do an excursion, they may take you to another part of Half Moon Cay, but like I said, great times. We're gonna see what tonight brings me, and definitely looking forward to what they have in store. I'm not sure where the beach party is gonna be at, but I'll have all the content for you. All right, see y'all soon. All right, family, so I'm headed to the buffet real quick to grab me something to eat, and then I'm gonna head outside. It's like around like 7:25, so I'm gonna grab me something to eat real quick and then head out. Check out the beach bash and the light show that they have with the lighthouse. And then tonight is gonna be a lot that's going on. So we have the Love and Marriage show and there's some other parties that's at the La Cabaret Rouge. So it's gonna be a full night. So stay with me, y'all. Stay with me.
Hey guys, so I got something simple, mashed potatoes, some fish fillet, grilled pork, rice, and some vegetables, so nothing too major. That's it. It's not bad. It's not bad. Not too bad. Rice tasting like that rice as well. Fish. Our fish is good. Check out this grilled pork. Trying to cut it without a knife. Grilled pork is pretty good. I'm going to pass on the grilled pork. But let me finish eating my food and we head over to the beach bash. All right, guys, so it's kind of windy out here. So I'm headed back to the beach area. It's getting kind of dark, but look how beautiful the ship is at night. Head over to the beach party.
Vamos, mami, let's go, ay, ay, ay.
Let's get some volume.
boy. Okay, MSC. Okay. I see I got something going on here. Man, let me tell you something. Big huge kudos to MSC with a light show. Two light shows, 8 o'clock and 9 o'clock, and they had an awesome beach party. I mean, just having the private island itself, like I said before, it's beautiful. But added on the beach party, added on the light show at the lighthouse, it truly makes, you know, cruising like extra special, you know, really, really extra special, having that added feature to it. And I mean, I know some other cruise lines have like a beach party like Virgin Voyages does, but I know Royal Caribbean doesn't, Carnival doesn't have that like kind of a beach party thing per se, if I'm not mistaken. If I'm wrong, let me know, because I know, I think there used to be sailings, or I thought that Royal Caribbean may have had some sailings where it stayed over in Coco Key overnight, and I'm not sure if they have like any type of beach party or anything like that. So if they do, I'm sorry, but I'm not aware of it. But I mean, what an excellent beach party. So now I'm about to head over to the Love and Marriage show. So they do have that on board, because I thought they didn't. It's at 10:15 and the Cabaret Rouge. And then it's basically a night of just in the Cabaret Rouge, just music, DJ, and ending the night off like that. So we'll see how that goes. You know, the Love and Marriage show is pretty funny. So I'll see how well it goes, and I'll see y'all soon.
That got something in it that I had
before. People are starting to filter in to watch the Love and Marriage show. And we were discussing how they need to change up the venue, because there's a lot of people that can't see down here. The MSC got to change that. But we'll see how this goes. Hopefully some good laughs.
Bastos over here. Let's give a big round of applause for our cruise activities manager, Bastos. Now, Bastos, the word around the street is that you are indeed married, correct?
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, how long have you been married for?
3 years.
3 years?
Yeah,
okay, moving with. So now, can you tell the audience, what is the secret to marriage?
In Canada, put your hands together for Steven and Jennifer! UK, 29 years together. Put your hands together for Mike and Jay.
So far.
We have to wait, so I don't know.
No, you'll find out along the way. Okay, very good. Let's give a big round of applause for couple number one, 2 weeks. All right, moving over here. Jennifer, how long have you two been together and where did you meet?
11 years.
Oh, okay. Oh yeah.
Did you wear this jersey so he would remember how many years you were together? Okay, and where did you meet?
Hooters?
Okay, and Hooters. Very good. All right, very good. Give a big round of applause for couple number two. I'm not going to ask any more questions, okay? All right, couple number three, Mike and Jan, you're from the UK. And Mike, why don't you tell us, what do you love most about your wife?
Everything.
Ah, good, couple little bonjos here for couple number three. We have massages.
Yeah.
All right, so we're coming. The men just went off.
We don't have any of that.
Now it's the ladies' turn to answer questions.
All right, ladies, are we ready? Yeah? No, she says no. Okay, so here's how it works. We're gonna ask three. Is it B, Can't Stop Till You Get Enough by Michael Jackson? Is it C, Like a Virgin? Or D, All by Myself?
B.
B, Michael Jackson, Can't Stop Till You Get Enough. Give it up for couple number two.
Good boy. All right.
All right, Wilson. Same question.
Good luck.
A, B, C, or D?
I'm gonna go with B.
B, Can't Stop Till You Get Enough?
That is not correct.
2 weeks. 2 weeks. Okay, we got to work on this. We'll see you again in 20 years, okay? Very good.
Sorry, girl.
All right. Over here. A, B, C, or D?
What leg in?
A, you shook me all night long. B, can't stop till you get enough. C, like a virgin. Or D, all by myself?
B.
B, wow. Can't stop till you get enough. Give it up for couple number three.
Don't stop till you get enough.
Ruben was in Miami, and he went to the Victoria's Secret shopping store, and he bought you a bra. What size bra would he buy you?
I thought 32 double D.
Richard?
Ooh, not quite. Close, but not quite. He said 34B.
34B. We're close. Very good. Okay, we're still learning though. 2 weeks in. Give each other a kiss. Good try. Now you know.
Now I know. Alright.
Alright, we'll go over here.
Let's go over there.
Okay. Jan, your husband goes and buys you a bra. What size bra would he buy you?
It's okay, you have time until Bahamas, until tomorrow or today.
I think it's a 30-40.
Oh, my God. Wonderful celebration because it's going all downhill right here.
Oh my God.
All right, Jennifer.
Doesn't matter, it's on the floor.
Oh my God. I must say, you two are meant to be. You're very meant to be, okay? What size bra? You got to give us a number and a letter. Or letters. Or letters.
Or a complete sentence.
3, but
wow.
So 38B.
38B. Richard. Richard.
Et cetera.
Yes. Richard, why don't you go ahead and tell us what Steven said.
I almost ran out of space driving it. He said 55 triple F.
55 triple F. No.
What a day, guys. What a day. Man, just got back in. The Love and Marriage show was funny as usual. And then afterward, there was a party in the Lake Cabaret Rouge. And I stayed there for about like 40 minutes and I'm tired. Tired, man. Man. And then tomorrow it's Nassau. It's crazy because I just looked on the map and we're really, really close to Miami, like super close to Miami. And the way we're going, it's like weird. So I don't know why we're going the direction we're going, but hopefully we will make it to Nassau tomorrow. And I don't even know what to do because my mother has never been to Nassau. I've been to Nassau probably like 7 or 8 times. So I might just actually just we walk out and we'll get maybe like a local tour guide to just show us around some of the places of Nassau. And then I definitely want to try out a Bahamian restaurant. So I'm going to do a little bit of research tonight. To try to find a pretty good Bahamian restaurant in near the downtown area or maybe a little bit away from the downtown area that has pretty good food. So, but yeah, looking for some good food. Looking for some really good food, man. Oh my goodness, cannot tell you. I cannot wait to get home. Like, this is the first cruise I'm like, man, I cannot wait to get home and eat some food. Oh man, I'm not saying the food here is horrible, but it's just, it's not it. But anyway, I'm about to take it in and rest up for tomorrow, last day, day number 8. And then Sunday, got a pretty long morning and got the debarkation, and then got about a 3.5 hour drive back to the Orlando area back home. So hopefully the traffic is not bad since it's a Sunday and we're getting back kind of early. So I'm looking to like fly back home. So thank you guys, man. Beautiful day, man. It was a nice day. And I really don't have any complaints at all. Not saying that I like to complain, but it was a really good day. MSC, like I said, did a really good job with the beach party and the lighthouse show. That was a really nice touch to already a really nice private island that they have here. So, everyone, love you guys. And I will see you all tomorrow. Take care.